As you're maneuvering around on this foggy kind of evening, kind of damp and raw out there, you're probably not thinking severe weather, but we've got a severe thunderstorm watch in effect until 11 o'clock for counties west of the river. This severe thunderstorm warning that had been in effect until 6:15, gone now. That was for Perry, Mifflin, and Juniata counties primarily. That now has expired, but still, you can see some heavy rain in here, and it's making its way across the west shore and into the Harrisburg area as we speak. This is the watch area that was just discontinued, and so now we'll watch this continue to make its way from west to east. And just in western Pennsylvania alone, you've got a number of watches and warnings and place. Strong storms up here. Somerset, Bedford County seem to be getting hit pretty good today. There's still a tornado watch back to the south and west of Pittsburgh as well. Not for us. We do have that severe thunderstorm watch in place, but this whole line is going to be moving over the Susquehanna Valley over the next, say, 2 to 3 hours. Here's a satellite and the radar picture. This is actually from SkyTracker to start us off. You can see a lot of lightning in here. And you can also see a pretty well-defined band of snow on the northern edge of this. They're picking up significant snow across New York State, moving into New England right now. For us, we're warm enough that it's going to stay all liquid this evening, and it will come down pretty good, and some gusty thunderstorms are likely with this. Temperatures 38 to 42. Still keeps us in the really raw category, doesn't it? Rain ends overnight, actually probably late evening, early tonight, and then a few flurries may be around, 34 to 38 degrees. Tomorrow, any flurry activity, which would be around sunrise, will be done. We'll start to clear out by afternoon, some nice sunshine, but it's going to be a breezy to windy day. Winds 15 to 25 miles an hour, and top temperatures will only be in the low 40s, unseasonably cool, as we are right now, 40 in Harrisburg, 39 in Lancaster, 41 in York. The reason these storms are enjoying a pretty good life out here is because it's much more humid and it's much warmer. As you look down to the southwest there, in the 60s still, and Pittsburgh was close to 70 this afternoon. For us, though, we've been locked in around the 40-degree mark. Humidity's 97%. Winds are from the east at 12 miles an hour. Just under 3/10 of an inch of rain so far. We're not done with the system yet, of course. We did have a trace of snow officially. The high was 42, and the low so far, 34 degrees. So the satellite and the radar view shows this whole mass of moisture kind of coming in waves today, you know, rounds of rain, gray and dreary out there. Watch things start to fire up this afternoon, coming out of Indiana and into Ohio and Kentucky and Tennessee. The center of this is going to pass right over us this evening, and that's when we see most of our rain this evening with some thunder thrown in. And then by midnight or thereabouts, most of that precipitation's gone, and some chilly air wraps in on the backside of this storm to change over what minuscule amount of moisture is left to flurries or maybe a snow shower. Notice tomorrow we clear out. Thanks to high pressure, it'll be a windy day, but at least sunshine's coming back. Same thing on Friday. More sunshine, but chillier than average temperatures by about 13 degrees or so. Friday's high 40. We should be around 53 or 54 degrees by that time. On Saturday, increasing clouds. On Sunday, there's a chance of a little touch of snow or rain as the system goes by to our south. There's also a chance that might just bypass us. That's going to be a very close call and not a big issue for us. 46 on Monday with a chance of some more rain or snow on Tuesday. So, as I said before, just kind of an unusual day outside today.
Unusually ugly.
Thank you, Doug.